मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर कंटिन्यूइंग लेसन नंबर 8, नेटवर्किंग कॉन्सेप्ट्स. चिल्ड्रन, लास्ट टाइम वी डिस्कस्ड एडवांटेजेस एंड डिसएडवांटेजेस. फर्स्ट एडवांटेज ऑफ नेटवर्किंग इज सेंट्रल स्टोरेज ऑफ डेटा. इन नेटवर्किंग चिल्ड्रन, फाइल्स डेटा स्टोर्ड ऑन अ सेंट्रल कंप्यूटर नोन एज ए फाइल सर्वर्स. देयर कैन बी वन और मोर सर्वर्स एंड दैट डेटा कैन बी शेयर्ड एंड अवेलेबल टू ईच एंड एवरी वन इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन दैट इज द पार्ट ऑफ दैट ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. So, data is centrally stored, it is not scattered. File sharing. Networking gives the advantages of file sharing. We can easily share data between different people, different branch offices, and it is very fast service because we can quickly share our files. We don't have to go to the seat to seat in a company, in a school, in an organization to share our files and data. Resource sharing. Children, networking give the advantages of resource sharing. Resources like printers, scanners, photocopiers, even we can share the softwares also between multiple users. It saves money. We don't have to purchase separate printer for every seat. Even we can share the printer between one or more departments if there is a less printing work. Sharing a single internet connection. Children, networking has one more advantage, that is we can share single internet connection in our local area network where multiple computers are using the single internet connection. Reliability. In networking, it gives us the facility of backup and our data is backup on some other computer. That is a part of networking. If suppose in due to some reason our computer is not working or we lost our data is inaccessible on our PC, then we can use another PC and the duplicate copy of that data in the networking and we can do our work properly. Security through authorization. Children, in networking give the facility of sharing. But it also gave the security features. Every person only use the data, access the data with proper login ID and password. So, unauthorized person cannot access the data. It reduced data redundancy. In networking, data is stored centrally, so it reduced duplication of data in the organization. Everyone in the organization only get the updated copy of that data. Enables all types of file sharing. In networking, we can share text files. Also, we can share various types of softwares. We can share audios, videos with each other. Fast communication. Network users can quickly communicate with each other. They can use email, instant messaging services for the communication. Computer network make it easier to collaborate on a one project. In networking, people can work as a team on a one project from different places and they can share their documents, they can work on a designs, programming, they can send email to each other and this way it is possible to work on a one project. Computer network can transfer enormous file sizes in seconds. Children, nowadays we can use Dropbox, iCloud and other services that allow us to share the files that are measured in terabytes, not the megabytes. Even we can share a access link with others. Now children, we also discuss some disadvantages like first virus and malwares. When we are using the network, it is chance that virus can be come to our computer through the network and it can corrupt our important files. It can just affect the functioning of our computer. Also, it can affect the functioning of networking system. Second is cost of network. Children, to execute the networking, it includes cable, equipments. It is an expensive procedure. Or also managing a large networking is also very complicated. For that, we require the trainings, we require network manager, that is costly. Hacking. In networking, there is a danger of hacking, but we need a tight security measures like firewall and other security measures. Robustness. In networking, all the computers are depend on a main server. In that case, if main server breaks down, other system also cannot do their work. Sometimes you have seen in the bank that bank officers are saying that they cannot just use the software because there is a problem of networking, because the data is on the central computer, and if there is a problem in a networking, if the central computer is not working, the other computers that are connected with that server computer cannot access the data. Now children, we discuss some components of a network. First, network interface card. Children, a network interface card is a hardware component which allow computer to connect with the network. Without it, computer cannot connect with the network and computer cannot share data and files with other computers in a network. It is a circuit board which is installed in a computer and it provides connection to the computer. It is also known as a network interface controller, network adapter or LAN adapter. Every computer that is connected in the network, children, has a network interface card. And there are two types of network interface cards are wired interface card, where cables are used to connect the computers. We use Ethernet cable to connect with the port of network interface card, and then computer connects with the networking. Nowadays, network interface card built in with motherboard, children. Another is wireless interface card. In this computer system, network interface card use Wi-Fi signals, and wireless network interface card need to be inserted in the motherboard. However, no network cable is required to connect to the network. Only it is just inserted into motherboard, but to connect with the network there is no need of cable. They use wireless signals. As you can see in this picture, every computer has a wireless interface card, and through that they are connecting with switch and they can share the information. Next is hub. Children, it is also an important networking device that connects the multiple computers, and also it connect the computers of other networks. Two or more computers cannot communicate with each other directly, children. They need hub. All the computers are connected with the hub, and then they can then send and receive data. Hub allow computer to connect with its ports, and then computers can share data resources. But children, hub is not an intelligent device. It cannot manage the flow of data. It sends data to every computer without considering destination of data. And that is the reason every computer receives the same information, and it slows down the speed of transmission on networking, because data is going to each and every computer. And hub consists of set of RJ45 ports, and all the computers are connected with an Ethernet cable with RJ45 connected to these ports. So this way hub works in networking. Thank you.